Hi, welcome to the third part of the Inspector URcap tutorial series. My name is Nils and I work as an application engineer here at SICK, and I'm the developer of this UR Plus plugin. In this part, I will show you how to use the extra data fields in the Inspector URcap by making a measurement with the SICK Inspector PIM60 and send this measurement to the UR robot. We'll use the same object that we used in the first tutorial to measure the diameter of this circle. As an example, we can use this to tell if our located object is a good or defective object and separate them from each other. If you haven't seen the first tutorial about how to configure the SICK Inspector PIM60 and create a simple vision-guided pick-and-place application, please watch this by following the link in the description below. We will start this tutorial by opening SOPAS and connect to our inspector. When connected to the inspector, we can press the edit button and then choose the reference object we used in the first tutorial. Then we go to the reference image, choose the circle tool and place it over the circle in the object we have. And you can see that the inspector calculates the settings for us here. We can go to the results tab, and in here we can see that our diameter of this circle is 29.11 millimeters. We can also try to put another object with a smaller circle and see what measurement we get from that one. So here we have 19.9 millimeters. Final thing we need to do is to edit our Ethernet output string to actually send this measurement to the UR robot. So in the output string, we have the decision, X, Y, Z coordinates, and the rotation. And we can here add the extra data fields that we want. The Inspector URcap supports up to 16 extra data fields. So here we choose the circle tool and in the circle tool we want the diameter. Oh, should have it here. Nice. And we also need a comma and space after the rotation. We can now validate our output string and see that we get extra data field with the diameter of the circle, which in for this smaller circle is 19.9 millimeters. We can apply this, press OK button, put our inspector in run mode and save our settings to flash, and move on with the robot program. We can now continue to edit the program we had from the first tutorial. First of all, we go to the Move to Campus node, and under the Advanced tab, we check the Publish Extra Sensor Data as Global Variable. And we only have one extra data field in this case, so we leave that to one. When we run this program the first time, we will see that the extra data fields variable are under the variables tab. But be able to use this, we need to define it in a before start sequence. So we add an assignment set the variable to 6 data, and the extra data fields are published as a array. So we need to define it as an array, and we set the first element in the array to 0, since we only have one extra data field. We can now use this after we located our object. So we can go to the object and grip it, and then make a if statement. So in here we can look at the SICK data, and the first element of the SICK data array, to see if the diameter of the circle is less than 29, or maybe we should say 28 millimeters. So if it's less than 28 millimeters, we can go to one waypoint, and if it's more than 28 millimeters, we can go to another waypoint. So we can copy the waypoints we had from the first tutorial. Maybe we can actually lift it up before we check this. Then we add a else statement, and in the else statement we add a new waypoint. So for the first, in the first tutorial we dropped off the object here. So in this case we will drop off the objects with the smaller diameter in this location, and the objects with the larger diameter in this location somewhere here. We'll set this waypoint. And when we're at the waypoint, we open our gripper. So let's try with our first object with the large diameter. And it goes to this location. It's the object with the smaller diameter. And it goes to this location. You now have an overview on how to use the extra data fields to send measurements and inspections from the SICK Inspector PIM60 to the Eurorobot. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe to the SICK YouTube channel, and also to watch the other parts in the Inspector URcap tutorial series.